After 8 years of construction, it was completed in 1932, and ever since, the Harbour Bridge has put Sydney on the world map. Instantly recognisable and unmistakable, the Sydney icon has seen it all. That is, until today, when Australia's one and only Formula One driver Mark Webber puts his BMW Williams into overdrive. More than 200,000 cars batter the bridge daily, but today, one is all that's needed to rock her. It truly is one of the most recognisable landmarks in the world, and today the Sydney Harbour Bridge will again be the focal point of global media. And Aussie F1 star Mark Webber has crossed oceans, continents and thousands of finish lines in his career thus far, but today a crossing of a difference. Hello everyone, I'm Lee Diffie and welcome to Overdrive. Yes, this morning Mark Webber will drive his BMW Williams Formula One car across the Sydney Harbour Bridge. It's quite an eerie sight behind us, isn't it? No traffic. Good morning everyone, and good morning to our F1 expert commentator Neil Crompton. Who would ever have thought this would happen?
Good morning, Lee. It's amazing, isn't it? Quite a surreal scene for an empty bridge behind us like this, but a fantastic moment for Australian motorsport in many respects, and it really pays tribute to the incredible performance of Mark Webber, previously with Jaguar and Minardi, but the efforts that he has gone to reach that point, quite extraordinary, and a good thing for Australian motorsport that we're able to celebrate his role in a top three team like this in 7 days from now at the Australian Grand Prix.
Yeah, we are gearing up for the Foster's Australian Formula One Grand Prix, just 7 days' time. It's an awesome build-up, isn't it? I mean, this is going to be seen around the world.
Great promotion. I mean, a really fantastic thing. And a bit of pressure on the boy at the moment. He's kind of pacing around in circles with his fingers crossed. I have popped him the $3 to make sure he can get through the toll okay without getting pinged. But no, this is a great thing. And it's terrific for us to be able to celebrate. Fantastic car, a really terrific Australian sporting character, and a real great moment for Australian motorsport.
Exciting times for Mark Webber. He is now a part of one of F1's cornerstone teams, BMW Williams. Here's a closer look. There has always been a strong bond between Williams and Australia after Alan Jones clinched the 1980 World Drivers' title. And now that Mark Webber is a part of the family, the bond is even stronger. Williams expect Webber to deliver this year, and so too his teammate Nick Heidfeld. Brazilian Antonio Pizzonia fills the role of test and reserve driver. Although it's only Webber's fourth year in F1, he is seen as the team leader after his amazing work ethic and attitude naturally placed him in that position at Minardi and Jaguar.
Mark Webber is clearly, we believe strongly, a driver with a great future ahead of him. Grand Prix drivers are always coloured by their cars. They need a winning car to be winners. It's good or bad, that's how it is. And we hope to deliver Mark for the first time in his career, maybe a real opportunity to win races. We sincerely hope so.
The man behind the name is Sir Frank Williams, a former driver himself, but far more effective as a team owner. Wheelchair bound since a car crash in the mid-80s. BMW Williams F1 is a cornerstone team in Formula One and has been in existence since 1977. Frank Williams can proudly boast he has guided his team to 9 constructors and 7 drivers' championships. Sir Frank's right-hand man is Patrick Head. The former technical director, now director of engineering, is as much Williams as Sir Frank, except he has a different last name. Head has overseen the design and construction of every F1 car Williams has ever produced. Mark Webber is the obvious Aussie at Williams, but there is another major influence at the British team. The technical director is West Australian-born, Canberra-raised Sam Michael. He came to Williams with experience from Lotus and Jordan. Having already worked with Ralf Schumacher at Jordan, he engineered Heinz-Harald Frentzen to 2 victories at Williams. His new role brings with it huge responsibility and expectation. 4th in last year's Constructors' Championship was very un-Williams. This is a team that's used to being at the top and has been for decades. Mark Webber has a wonderful opportunity to be the driving force behind Williams' ascent to F1's top spot, and he's relishing it.
We're now clearly aiming at a different level to compared to the teams I've driven for in the past, but it's a huge boost for me. I'm looking forward to it. Can't wait to get going.
That gives you a good indication the quality of the team that Mark Webber is now driving for. In a week's time in Melbourne, in Albert Park, it will be business, serious business. But this morning, time for a little enjoyment, and the man of the moment, Mark Webber, is with our Neil Crompton.
Mark, this must surely rank as one of the more bizarre things that you've ticked off in your career to date.
Absolutely. I think I'd never in my wildest dreams expect them to close a bridge to run a Formula One car across it, but a really special day, obviously. You know, you've got the Aussie flags on top of the bridge. When you grow up as a young Australian, the Sydney Harbour Bridge is incredibly famous, and also for all the Europeans and in America, all the people around the world watching this today, it's a great image.
You brought all the heavyweights with you. You've got Dickie Stanford, team manager. You've got Sam Michael, technical director. You've got all the people required here to break the lap record, but not required here this weekend, but next weekend certainly.
Absolutely, yeah. All the guys, I mean, they've been excited about it ever since it was announced that we're going to try and do this, and with the help of the Grand Prix Corporation, BMW, everyone involved, New South Wales government, and the whole thing together. I mean, it's very special event, and I hope that we can have a good day here today, but like I say, next weekend is where the serious stuff starts.
It's a tremendous spectacle. I mean, a Formula One car, the Sydney Harbour Bridge, it must make you feel genuinely proud. It is a special moment.
No question about it. I think I definitely look back and you'd be very very happy about it. I'm a little bit nervous, which is absolutely crazy, but it's actually, you know, I'm not even racing. I don't get this nervous when I'm racing, so I just want it to go well, and just for everyone, all the effort that's gone in.
I can see you pacing around before and you had that look on your face. Go and jump in, we'll talk to
Thanks.
You shortly.
Yeah, cheers. Bye-bye.
Thanks, mate.
Mark's looking forward to it. The team are looking forward to it. So are we. You are watching Network 10's live and exclusive coverage of Mark Webber's Sydney Harbour Bridge crossing. When we return, we will go into overdrive. Sydney Harbour on a Sunday morning, and we are preparing for overdrive. Welcome back, everyone. 10's live and exclusive coverage of Mark Webber, our one and only Formula One driver in the BMW Williams. There it is, the FW26. Mark is now inside the cockpit. They've just fired the engine, and we're getting set to see a spectacle we've never seen before, and more than likely we'll never see it again.
Fantastic, isn't it? And Mark in and buckled up. It's quite a process getting in the car, Lee. As you know, it's about a two and a half minute process to be able to get the 6-point harness fastened. Shot of the mirror as Premier of New South Wales waves away Mark Webber in the FW26. This is in fact the car that Juan Pablo Montoya, the Colombian, used to win the Brazilian Grand Prix at the end of the 2004 championship season. This team have done something in the order of 25,000 kilometres since we last saw them in October. 11,000 with their new car, the 27, which race debuts next weekend. And here's Webber in the middle of the Sydney Harbour Bridge with, of course, for safety reasons, speed limited. And you can see the car just bucking as it jumps across the expansion joints in the bridge. This is the tricky part. He's got to get the thing turned around. The steering lock available on these cars is so limited, he'll have to actually half flick spin the car or be pushed backwards, which he's actually called for
now.
He's
asking for it, isn't it? Yeah. BMW Williams crew down there. They ferried those guys down there earlier. Well, not ferried, but took down in a road car. Mark getting some assistance. The first time a Formula One car to cross the Sydney Harbour Bridge.
In order to be able to do this, they have to wind ride height into the car, pick it up. I spoke to Sam Michael, actually had to lift it up around about 100 mil, which is dramatically higher than the car would normally run. Even though in a road car, when we cross the Harbour Bridge, you think it's pretty smooth. In terms of racing cars, it's not. You see the flags on top of the bridge, a bit of an easterly blowing through the harbour this morning, and the echoes of the BMW P84 engine, good for nearly 900 horsepower and 19,000 RPM, and a little 180 degree flick spin on the southern end of the Harbour Bridge approach.
And the surrounding high-rise hotels here on the harbour. The hotel guests got a terrific vantage point. Lots of fans gathered down below the Sydney Harbour Bridge, and they're watching it on a big screen, live and exclusive here on 10.
And Mark will be going down there immediately after this little presentation this morning to just mingle with race fans. A huge week for him. He said that he's managed to calm things down in the next couple of days. This time he gets the car around comfortably. Grabs first gear. Not an easy thing to manoeuvre one of these cars.
No.
Quite awkward to turn. And you can see now and here with a little bit more warmth in the car, he's able to just use a bit more of it. And as he drove away from the southern side there before, it was first, second, third and fourth before you could even blink an eye. The performance of these cars is really quite staggering.
And for Mark, who grew up in Queanbeyan, not necessarily a Sydney sider, but this is a huge moment for him and a great build-up to next week's Foster's Australian Formula One Grand Prix.
We must thank, Lee, the various authorities involved to make this happen. There are so many New South Wales authorities that have combined to coordinate something like this. I mean, it seems and sounds like a relatively simple thing until you go and try and do it. And many, many people have come together, hundreds if not thousands, in the past weeks to be able to coordinate this in such a way that we're able to celebrate Mark's involvement in this team, BMW Williams, for 2005. It'll be the fourth appearance in the Australian Formula One Grand Prix for him next weekend. His best performance was his debut run there with Minardi fifth and the last couple of years with Jaguar. Qualified sixth last year, but unfortunately didn't finish the race on both occasions, and certainly hoping for big things with this new car for 2005.
What a sight. And the level of interest on a global scale in this event, albeit promotional, there's some 1,800 journalists will be at the Formula One Grand Prix next weekend. And I can tell you there's a large contingent here this morning. German, Japanese, English have come from all around the world to watch this BMW Williams and Mark Webber cross the Harbour Bridge. What a beautiful sight.
That raspiness that you can hear in the background is the traction control being initiated on the car. And it limits power to the rear wheels. And it clears itself once the aero comes on the car. You know, at 200-odd kilometres an hour, there's well over 1.5 tonnes of aerodynamic downforce on these cars, and that's nothing like its peak speed. In fact, Pizzonia last year at the Italian Grand Prix in Monza, in one of these cars, the FW26, was clocked at 369 kilometres an hour on the straight. Quite amazing.
Mark will be teamed with German Nick Heidfeld this year, and Brazilian Antonio Pizzonia, who was his former teammate at Jaguar, is the test driver for BMW Williams.
The reason for all the focus is the great pedigree of this race team, Lee. 9 Constructors' Championships, 7 Drivers' Championships for Williams, and a great deal of affection for this team in Australia dating back to the late 70s when Alan Jones joined the team, became world champion in 1980 and stayed with the team again through 1981. Setting off one of the great partnerships, Sir Frank Williams, Patrick Head, who at that point was technical director, and Alan Jones. And there's a lot of faith and a lot of anticipation in terms of the relationship between Sam Michael, the young Australian technical director of this team, and Mark, under the tutelage of Sir Frank and Patrick Head. In fact, I spoke to Sam earlier on, and when he came to town, the first thing he wanted to do was enjoy some of the great things about Sydney.
Yeah.
So he went surfing yesterday at Freshwater.
And there's that fabulous chopper shot again. Great way of combining 3 terrific cities, isn't it? Of course, Melbourne has its main event next weekend. Today, it's Sydney's chance. But for the 2 Australians in this team, for Mark Webber and Sam Michael, both raised in the Canberra region. Sam Michael, West Australian born, but grew up in Canberra. And this is Mark's final crossing, his final up and back. And he was a little nervous when you spoke to him before, Neil, but he'll be loving it now.
Yeah, he's at home now and obviously comfortable in the car. Since October, and there was a testing ban at one point for 6-odd weeks, this team have done just over 25,000 kilometres and 11,000 kilometres in their new car. So he actually just came down from Valencia in Spain where they wrapped up testing with the FW27. They've got a raft of new components being built right now back in the factory at Grove in Oxfordshire, about an hour to the northwest of London. They'll be air freighting those components down for the Grand Prix in Melbourne next weekend, and obviously anticipating a strong showing down there. But it is going to be a fascinating season of Formula One on Network 10. A lot of question marks in terms of whether or not Ferrari can hold sway. They'll be starting the season with a modified version of their 2004 car. A lot of anticipation in terms of the performance of both Renault and McLaren, and action behind with Williams, Toyota and a bunch of others who I think are going to be very competitive. A big round of applause for Mark Webber as he completes his Harbour run.
Terrific effort from Mark, and when we return on the other side of this break, we will chat with our F1 star. There it is, a shot we will remember forever. Mark Webber in his BMW Williams across the Sydney Harbour Bridge. Stunning stuff. Hello everyone, Lee Diffie and Neil Crompton with the man of the moment, Mark Webber. How was that?
Yeah, pretty good. It's very bumpy, obviously. These cars are designed, obviously, for racetracks, and to go over a bridge, obviously, there's a lot of movement going on in terms of the structure itself over the years. But it's absolutely incredible experience. Very, very good. And to hear the echo under the bridge and things were shifting gears and the power was fantastic, yeah.
What about I saw the thing leap over one of the joins, one of the expansion joints in the bridge there, and it looked at one point like you're going to bounce out of the cockpit.
I was, even in a straight line, I had to be careful because these tyres also absolutely rock hard because they're obviously promotional tyres, not really race tyres as such, so very slippery on the turns here as well.
Quite difficult to do those flick spins?
Well, because we had to flick in the traction control on and off and things, and also, because the tyres had no temperature at all, because we kept just going, we're not really using the tyres that hard, so I didn't have the room to do a slow turn. They haven't got the turning lock, so I had to give it a little bit of a boot for to get around.
What did you think in terms of the experience of driving up and down here and what it means to do that time?
Very special, obviously. I had to concentrate on what I was doing, so to try and really, really enjoy it, I suppose. It'll come a little bit later, but it was good fun. Like I said before, it's an incredible moment for me to share this with all the team and everyone from BMW and Williams. The whole thing is great.
On to the serious business of next weekend. How has the testing gone so far with the next car in line, the 27?
It's gone okay. We would like to have a little bit more pace in the car, obviously, before the first race. I think some of the other teams have a little bit more pace than us at the moment, but it's a long championship, and of course, I would really love to do well in front of my home fans and in the first race. It's always good to start the season strongly as well. So I will be giving absolutely everything to put the car up as far as I can and also finish as high as we can. There's a lot of unanswered questions for next week's race. All the teams have a lot of things to sort out, so we'll see how it goes.
One of the things that looks as though, from afar at least, that has been strong with your cars, though, has been reliability. That's obviously a strong point. And the way in which the rules are structured for 2005 with two-race engine format, that's going to be very important.
It is, yeah. But testing, as we always say, is one thing and racing is another. And I hope that it does pan out. Like I say, we get a slight advantage from that in terms of our preparation on the reliability side. Grove, meaning Williams, have done a very good job. Gearbox, hydraulics, all the things which can go wrong. I think they've done a reasonable job there for sure. BMW also done a good job. But we know who we're up against. The opposition's awesome as well. And you can't kid yourself. You're not out there on your own.
With the harder compound tyres with only one set available now for qualifying in the race and the two-race engine format and quite a number of little behind-the-scenes changes, have the cars altered dramatically to drive compared to the personality of this car?
Not really, no. A lot of the things are invisible for the driver, especially the engine. Obviously, you lose a little bit of power, and that'll be also invisible for the fans. But doing the whole race on one set of tyres is clearly something which does have a impact on the whole race. I think the last part of the races will be interesting, and especially the last stint, because normally we put fresh set of tyres on at every stop. Now that doesn't happen, and the tyre gets an absolute hammering when we put the fuel in, and that's what the tyre doesn't like. So we've tested that as much as we can, but so has everyone else.
All of the other opponents have been frantically testing as well. Most of you have been doing it in Spain, although there's been a test in Imola last week and also in the UK. What's your indication of your feeling now in terms of the way Ferrari, McLaren, Renault and others are shaping up against you guys?
Well, those three that you mentioned, they look strong. I think they could have a clear advantage over the rest of us. But who knows? We don't know what they're doing. And all we know is we know what we're doing, and we'd like to be doing a little bit better job at the moment. So we'll see how it goes.
When you talk about your new teammate for 2005, Nick Heidfeld, good guy?
Yeah, he is. Yeah, a lot of experience. He's driven in Formula One the last 5 years. He's had a few podium finishes with Sauber, and he knows his stuff. He's not he's no slouch. So both of us together, hopefully, can work hard with the team, and over the course of the season, get a lot of constructors' points and get Williams back up there.
Realistically, what do you think's likely to unfold for you next weekend? Where do you imagine that you'll fit into the field?
I hope both Williams finish and we get some points. Clearly won't be happy with 7th and 8th, but if that's all we can get because of the pace is very hot at the front and the reliability strong from the other teams, which I'm also expecting, it's not going to be Malaysia will be the tough race. I think Melbourne, a lot of teams will be reliable, so it's a bit conservative, but I won't be happy. I'm standing here, so I'm happy with it. It'll be disappointing, but we've just got to move on.
Well, you look like you've been training pretty hard. You look pretty fit, but you should have a bit of a blast over the bridge, do the bridge climb and see whether you can peel off another half kilo or so before next week.
Yeah, well, Sam's always on about the weight, so I've got to, but the bridge walk I think is absolutely amazing. I think I've got some friends that have done it, so I'll try and do that as well.
Thanks for your time this morning, mate. Fantastic.
No problem. Cheers.
There he is, Mark Webber, and a thoroughly enjoyable experience for him this morning. And we look forward to seeing him next weekend, 1 week's time, the Foster's Australian Formula One Grand Prix. We kick off our coverage, incidentally, this coming Friday. But as always, check your local guides, because we have got a very, very busy weekend coming up. Neil, what did you think about that in total?
I thought it was fantastic. I mean, obviously, I'm a hardcore motor racing fan myself and have been forever, and it's just a great thing for the industry, for the sport. I think the thing that impresses me most about the guy that's standing behind us is that, you know, he did this tooth and nail, clawed up from the very bottom of the sport, worked hard, never said die. Almost everybody in this country said that it couldn't be done, and in fact around the world, and he managed to do it. He's made it to Formula One. He not only made it to Formula One, he's now made it to a top team, and there's a battle. I mean, it's not going to be a question of just jumping into a blue and white car and suddenly disappearing off into the distance and standing on top of the podium. He knows it's going to be a big job, and I remind everybody to cast their minds back to when Michael Schumacher first joined Ferrari. That was no easy task. No. In the early days there, they really struggled. But this guy welds together his team. They love him. They love him back at the factory. They have rallied around him. They're all here. They talk positively about him this morning, and it'll take a little bit of time, but they will certainly get there. And you have to admire the fact that he has worked and worked and worked his backside off and never said die, despite some horrendous moments in his career, notably the Benz flipping over at Le Mans. I think you were there.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, there's been some incredible things, and he's managed to come through on the other side of that, which is fantastic. So all up, a fantastic thing this morning for all of us to be able to celebrate his involvement in a top team in Formula One across an icon like this wonderful old thing behind us, which I don't know whether you've ever been into that southeastern pylon, Lee, but you've actually got to get up there. It is a fantastic thing to do, and if you've not done it, I thoroughly recommend the bridge climb as well.
Talking about his path to Formula One, it truly has been a family affair, and it's great to see his mum and dad. They were just over here a moment ago. I spoke with them briefly, so a tremendous day for the whole family. Let's talk more about next weekend. We kick it off Friday, 3 days of live and exclusive coverage of the Foster's Australian Formula One Grand Prix, Friday, Saturday and Sunday, and as well as the F1. Don't forget, we will be bringing you the V8 supercars and various other races as well. We're looking forward to that.
Very much so. In fact, there's a lot to talk about with V8s as well. There's probably been a bigger, sillier season than we've had in a long time with so many drivers and teams moving around, but certainly the focus is going to be Formula One. There's so much to talk about. Rule changes, Mark's arrival at Williams. Really looking forward to being there for the 3 days. It's going to be very busy, but very exciting.
As you can imagine, huge logistical operation here today. We need to thank the likes of the New South Wales Police, the RTA, the Sydney City, BMW Williams, BMW Australia, so many people involved. And also a brief message on behalf of the RTA and New South Wales Police. Remember that this was completed in a controlled environment. We do remind you to obey the speed limit, as I know that you always do.
Indeed.
And it has been a fabulous day. Mark Webber has launched his Australian Formula One Grand Prix effort in style, you'd have to say.
Very much so. And he's got a couple of important days away from it all now. He's going to rest on Monday and Tuesday. He goes to Melbourne on Wednesday to settle in with the team. He's got a dinner on Wednesday night, and then he'll start to focus on the job at hand. And that's certainly going to be fascinating.
On behalf of the entire team and Neil Crompton, I'm Lee Diffie. Thanks for your company this morning. We'll see you next weekend from Albert Park.